Next question is, do you still use XP? Not on my main machines, no, of course not. It's 2018, it ended support 4 years ago, and it came out before you were probably even born, so like, yeah, no, I don't still use XP. I have it on one machine, and that's for old retro games, so that's it. So I technically have a machine that runs XP, which is my XP rig, which is Core 2 Duo E6700, 4 gigs of RAM, 750 gig hard drive, 2900 XT GPU, and that's about it. It's an older box, about 12 years old, so probably, honestly, older than you, even, maybe. Next question is, what is your favorite porn video? Someone tried to answer this for me. He said, I can answer this for you. It's a video I sent of him, of me jacking off. Oh god, that's gay. But no, that's not my favorite video. My favorite porn video is, this. Next question is, when my flight to Norway nosedives in the ocean at 500 miles an hour, what do you want me to leave you in my will? Also, can I borrow $13? Well, you don't have anything, I know that for a fact. You don't have anything that's worthwhile. So, like, let's see, what do you have that I'd want in your will? Let's see. Yeah, you don't have anything, dude. And also, can you borrow 13 bucks? Let me look with my wallet. Here, let's see if I can have 13 bucks to give you. Oh no, looks like I'm fresh out of money. Oh no, you can't have my 13 bucks because I don't have it myself. Next question is, why don't you use a phone call modem for Windows 95? I like that you do that. Doesn't really make any sense. So instead of using my iPhone, you want me to use a dial-up modem for that on a Windows 95 machine. Well, first, I don't have a 95 machine. I kind of want one, actually. I want a machine that's appropriate for Windows 95. I don't have one. So give me a Pentium MMX box, I'll be happy. Second, or maybe not MMX, but like, give me something from that era. I actually want one. Second, I mean, if I had to lug that around everywhere instead of just lugging around an iPhone, then, I mean, I would probably, that'd be a good workout, maybe, like, but I'm not that fat as it is. I already walk enough when I go to work, so, like, you know, it's, you know, I don't really need to, like, it'd be kind of inconvenient, to be honest, having to plug in, you know, that to make calls or whatever. And, like, I wouldn't be able to just browse Twitter or whatever, you know, like, that's, you know, and that's, so it's, well, maybe I could. Maybe I could install a browser that could find the mobile version of Twitter. That might work, actually. Next question is, can you do an internet tour? I can get inspiration. I mean, alright, so here is a tour of the internet. You have YouTube, which is where degenerates like me hang out. And then you also have Pornhub, which is also where degenerates like me hang out. So, and then you also have Reddit. So YouTube, Pornhub, and Reddit. That's all you need to know about the internet. Just those three sites, that's it. There's your internet. Next question is, do you regret getting the iPhone 10? No, I don't. I like it. Like I said earlier when someone asked me what are my thoughts on it, you know, I'm actually really enjoying the phone. Do I regret getting it? No. My phone bill isn't actually as expensive as I thought it would be. It's not as bad now, especially now that I'm actually earning an income. You know, I can afford this thing, and I actually got it before I even got my job. So, like, I started my job in late May. I got this about 2 months before then. Yeah, it's not a bad phone. Like, I don't regret getting it at all. I'm actually enjoying iOS more than I thought I would. I thought I would hate it, but I don't. What is my current favorite mobile platform? Well, let's see. The only current platforms that actually matter are iOS and Android. So, let's see. Windows Phone's dead. Has been for a couple years now. WebOS doesn't exist anymore. What else is there? There was that fucking shit Amazon was trying to pull with the Fire Phone or whatever. That's ancient. So really, there's only two mobile platforms that really exist now. That's iOS 11 and Android Oreo. Honestly, you can't really pick between the two. They both have good qualities. Like, in terms of features, then I guess, you know, Android, I don't know, I like both. Like, I played around with new Android phones, and I wish my Xperia would get Android 8.0. Maybe I might, I still have it, it's in my closet right behind me here. Sorry, in front of me here, you can't see it, but I might actually put 8.0 on that thing and try it out, but terms of, or not 8.0, but like whatever the current release of Android is, I might, you know, just load a ROM on there maybe, because it's not going to get the official one from Sony, I know that. But in terms of favorite, I don't like to pick favorites. That's probably one thing you've noticed, is that I don't pick favorites because I think that's stupid. It's either, I hate the whole mentality of being one side or the other, and it's not just tech that I'm talking about, I'm just talking about general life in general, how people are so competitive like that. But in terms of favorite, well, right now I'm using iOS 11, but, you know, I'd have no objection to using Android. I used Android before I even got my iPhone. I love it. You know, it's great. They're both equally as good as each other, and in different ways, though. That's what you have to understand, is that some people are just like, oh, iOS sucks, or oh, Android sucks. It's just like, no, they're both good in their own ways. You know, iOS is better in some ways, Android's better in others. And, you know, so they both kind of cancel each other out, really. Android has more features, but iOS has a bit more kind of more consistency, although in recent versions, not really. That's a bit of a nice meme. I don't know, they both have, you know, just, they're both good. So, like, they're the only platforms that matter. So, like, if Windows Phone was still around, I'd probably still be using it. You know, if it didn't have the app problem, which is what killed it in the first place, it was dead on arrival. Honestly, it was. Now that it's been a few years and I'm, you know, sort of can look at it a bit more objectively now, it was dead on arrival. It was great, I loved it, but it was dead on arrival. You can't deny that. But in terms of favorite, I don't really have a favorite because iOS and Android, the current releases of both of them, are just so good in their own ways that it doesn't matter to really choose. I don't like picking favorites, so I'm not going to. Next question is, do you keep all the builds that you built or do you sell them? Well, let's see, it depends on what, it depends on who the computer is built for. If I show a build on my channel that's not for me, I'll say that's not for me in the video, and obviously it won't be mine. I would have charged the client for parts and labor, like, but that's, you know, it's not my build, so I don't keep it anyway. As for the ones I build for myself, let's see, I still have all of the ones I've built in recent times. Well, with the exception of my old X79 Xeon rig, which I did sell because I didn't like it anymore. It was really unstable. I had problems, so I sold that because I needed to fund the Ryzen rig. So that thing went, and I'd mentioned that. So if I sell something, I'll usually mention it in whatever, if somebody replaces it or not. But all my current builds, the Ryzen machine obviously still exists. It's right behind me. My XP rig and my 98 rig are still there. I haven't shown the 98 rig off much lately. I haven't done a whole lot with it. I do want to eventually, once I find some time and the motivation to sort of deal with it again. Well, I shouldn't say deal with it. There's nothing wrong with it. It's just it hasn't even got an operating system installed on it yet. And I built it nearly a year ago now, so I need to get on that. But the XP rig, you know, is still around, of course. I do use that, actually, from time to time. So, and the LAN rig still exists, but it's currently not in a functional state, so I'm not sure what's going on with that. But it depends if I need the computer or not. If I build it, I'll use it for what I build it for, and then if I don't find a use for it later on, if my circumstances change, then I'll sell it. If not, then I won't sell it. I'll keep it. So, like, if I still have something and you still see it around, then I, you know, obviously still have it, but if I don't, then, you know, it probably might be sold, so who knows. I do tend to, like, sell things and not mention them. For example, I sold my T420, my ThinkPad T420. I didn't sell it, I traded it to my dad's laptop, and his one I'm gonna fix up and sell, so, like, but that's not mine anymore. As you can see, I'm not using a T420, I'm using this old sack of shit R61, so, because I don't have a laptop at the moment. But yeah, so do I keep builds that I build? Yeah, most of the time I do. And then if at some point if I don't need it anymore, then I'll flog it off to somewhere else. Next question is, do you think that video games are trash? If not, why? So are you talking about a specific video game? Or are you talking about just video games in general? Because if you're talking about video games in general, then I think you're a bit delusional, because I'm sitting in front of, you know, a computer I built for video editing and gaming, as well as two of the current generation consoles, the Xbox One and the PS4. So, like, and there's a 360 and a PS3 back there as well. You can't see them, and I'm in front of them. As well as a couple of retro gaming machines. So, clearly I like video games, right? So, you know, do I think they're trash, like, in overall? No, of course not. However, if you're talking about a specific game, then, you know, mention that specific game. Of course, there are games that are trash. I'll name a few of them. No Man's Sky, Assassin's Creed Unity, fucking Watch Dogs, all of those are garbage. I don't like them, you know, but there's also great video games. GTA 5, Doom, Doom 2016, even classic games like fucking Halo 2, you know, Need for Speed Underground 2, you know, those are all great games, you know. Gears of War. I'm just looking at some games that are in front of me right now. But yeah, like, there's games that are trash, there's games that are not. So it depends on what you're talking about. I think that question's a bit badly worded, but if you're talking about all video games, if you're asking if I think all video games are trash, then no. But there are a lot that are, there are tons that are trash, then there's, you know, quite a few that aren't. Even modern games. A lot of people like to say that modern games are shit. But it's just like, well, no, there's plenty of modern games that are good. It's just, it's kind of like music taste, really. A lot of people say, oh, modern music's all trash. And a lot of that's true. A lot of it is crap. But, like, there is good music. You just have to look for it. The same with video games. A lot of the AAA stuff is honestly garbage. I don't care about the newest Call of Duties anymore. I haven't cared about Call of Duty since Black Ops 1. That was 8 years ago. The new Battlefield it looks kind of okay, but not something I'm really generally interested in. You know, a lot of the mainstream AAA stuff, like Assassin's Creed or whatever, I don't give a shit about. But that's what would be considered modern and trashy. And stuff like Fortnite or PUBG, I don't care about any of those. PUBG, I could probably get into, but not Fortnite. The fuck that. Honestly, that's not my thing. But, like, you know, if you want to look for good games, look for them. There's tons of indie developers making great stuff, so, you know, that's just sort of my mini rant on that. So that question's a bit poorly worded, but yeah. Next question is, are you able to upgrade from Windows 1.0 to Windows 10 in a virtual machine? Well, all right, there's several reasons why I wouldn't want to do that. One, that's incredibly autistic. Two, it's incredibly time consuming. Three, I have a job, so I'm not gonna do that, all right? I'm earning a living. You know, so, like, I work a 9-to-5 job. I don't have time for any of that shit. So, like, no. Go find some fucking 12-year-old kid on YouTube that does that shit, not me. Next question is, how many phones have you had so far? Honestly, I've had quite a few over the last probably 12 or so years. I got my first one in 2006 when I was 9. Like I mentioned earlier, it was a Nokia 3210. After that, I got a Nokia 3315 because I found it in a drawer and I just swapped my SIM card out. Then I had a Nokia 5140i, which was a phone my grandfather used to have, and he got an upgrade to something else, I think a Nokia N8 at the time. This is like 2007. And so he gave me this one. It was my first phone with a camera, and it had a color screen. It was like a shock and water resistant phone. So, like, yeah, Nokia 5140i. Then I had a Motorola Razr V3. Yeah, it was my dad's old phone because he got a Razr. This is in 2008, he got a Razr 2. Then in 2009, I got a Razr 2 V9. Yeah, I got a Razr 2 V9 as well. Because I think, my mum got an upgrade and she didn't want it, so I got it. This is back, like, when you could actually still buy a Razr phone. No, the Razr 2 wasn't even that successful, but, you know, we had, you know, my dad had one and I had one too. Then I got an iPhone 3G. It was a phone, I didn't even need it at the time. I needed a phone at the time, but my Razr 2, I think the battery had stopped working, so I got given this old iPhone. This was in 2012. For a couple of years, I didn't have a phone. I had the Razr 2 for a couple of years, and then in 2012 I got the an iPhone 3G. It was a pretty smashed up iPhone 3G. I have a picture of it up on the screen here. I got it because I had a job, this was when I was like 15, I had a job mowing lawns, and so I just, you know, I needed a phone to, so people could call me saying, yo, come over on the weekend, mow my shit. And so, you know, I had a phone for that, basically. At the time, I had an iPod Touch and an iPad, so I didn't really... And an iPad... I had an iPad 2 and a fourth generation iPod Touch, which were both newer than that iPhone. So, like, I didn't even really... I used it for tethering mobile data, as well as just calls and text. That was it. The iPod Touch. And the iPod Touch and the iPad really served as my mobile devices back then. Then for a few months I didn't have a phone. Then I got my Lumia 520 in 2013 and used it for a couple of years. Then I got a Lumia 640 in 2015. I used it for about a little bit less than a year because then Windows phones sort of up and died. So then I got my Sony Xperia Z5 in 2016. And then I got my iPhone X. This year. I also had a Lumia 950 for a little while, just as, it was an impulse buy, because I really wanted to have a, I wanted to try the Continuum dock, so I found I saw a Lumia 950 on the Gumtree with a Continuum dock, just out of the blue. I wasn't even looking for one, I just saw one when I was looking for something else, and I was just like, it was cheap, so I bought it, and I sold it for basically just as much as I paid for it, so I didn't lose any money, because I wanted to try out that Continuum dock, and it wasn't even that good anyway, so, I mean, it was a nice piece of kit, but, like, the operating system was garbage, so, yeah, so let's see, how many phones was that, so 3210, 3315, 5140i, Razer V3, V9, Razer 2 V9, 3G, the iPhone 3G, Lumia 520, Lumia 640, Xperia Z5, and iPhone 10. So that's 10, yeah, it's 10 phones I've had. I thought it was more than that, actually. But yeah, I've had 10 phones, so far. And I plan on keeping this iPhone for as long as I can, actually. I plan on keeping this for a good while, so. So I really don't feel like I need to upgrade as much as I used to, so. Yeah, so I've had 10 phones. Next question is, if you were given a chance to change what's not great about the current tech industry, for example, computers, phones, game consoles, etc., what would you want to change? The one thing I'd want to change would be, if I had to change one thing, that would be how everyone just follows Apple. I know I just bought an iPhone. I bought their flagship device, the iPhone X. Because I genuinely like it, but what I don't like is how the rest of the tech industry just copies what Apple does, instead of actually innovating on their own. The best example of this is the headphone jack. Apple removed it so that they could have more room for the taptic engine, which is what's used with 3D touch. For example, when I press this flashlight icon down the bottom here, You can actually feel it, like, as if it was an actual button. In the iPhone 7, they wanted more room to put the haptic engine in there. At least that's what they say. They probably wanted to kill off the headphone jack anyway, because Apple loves to just kill off old technologies. They killed off the floppy drive. They killed off 5 1/4-inch floppy drives with the original Macintosh. They killed off regular floppy drives with the iMac. They killed off CD drives with the MacBook Air. And then they killed, let's see, they killed the headphone jack with the iPhone 7, so... And I don't like how the rest of the tech industry has followed that without adding any extra functionality. They just take the headphone jack out to make the phone thinner. Like, come on, this is thin enough! This is thin enough! How does a headphone jack not fit in this? I don't get it. This thing's bigger than an iPhone 7. How's the headphone jack not fit in this? Now, I don't expect Apple to put it back. And I went into this phone knowing that I wasn't gonna get a headphone jack. I was just gonna have to deal with a dongle, and I'm fine with it for the most part. It's a bit annoying, but you know, I'm still fine with it mostly. I can deal with it, but it's not something I like. And that's one thing. If there's one thing I had to change, it's that I don't like how the tech industry either piggybacks off the rest of the tech industry piggybacks off Apple or piggybacks off of Nintendo. Nintendo is sort of like the Apple of the gaming world. They just do what they want, and if something, you know, they do that the rest of the industry will like, the rest of the industry copies it, even if it's a bad thing. Same with Apple. If the Apple might do something strange and the rest of the industry may not like, or us consumers won't like, but the rest of the industry will just copy it anyway. How about copy parts of Apple that are actually good. Like their touchpads. Seriously. It's been 10 years since Apple came out with the multi-touch trackpads in their laptops, the big glass ones, and now we're only just now getting PCs with trackpads that are just as good. It took them a decade. How come 5 years ago we didn't have PCs with magnificent touchpads like that, you know, already? Like, we didn't. It took until only just now, and even now PC laptop touchpads suck, a lot of them. Unless you get like a Surface or a really high-end workstation laptop. And even then, they have kind of touchpads. Like, really, why hasn't anyone copied that? And I honestly, why not? Like, copy that instead. Don't copy the fucking removal of features that we like. That's the one thing I'll change, is everyone copies Apple, but for the wrong reasons. Next question is, have you wanted any other IBM ThinkPads besides the R51 that you have? Yeah, there are a few ThinkPad models I wouldn't mind having. Quite a lot, actually. I wouldn't mind having some of the classic 90s ThinkPads, like the original series, I think the, I forget what they're called, I think the 300 series. As well as there's a particular model that I know LGR, or Lazy Game Reviews, did a video of, where it had the keyboard that, like, sort of, as you open the laptop, the keyboard, like, sort of spread open. That's really neat. I would love to have one of those. That's really cool. Even if it's a really niche feature, I actually love it. Same with the 760 series, where it has the keyboard that sort of pops, like, you know, sort of, as you open the laptop, the keyboard sort of like raises up. That's really neat as well. I wouldn't mind having one of those. I think that's a 760 series ThinkPads. Those two models, as well as I wouldn't mind having an X series ThinkPad. I've never had one. I do like those. I wouldn't mind having, say, X41, X42, I think, maybe. I don't even know if that's a model. I know the X41 is. I wouldn't mind having like an X41 or an X60 or something. I do love those little 12-inch ThinkPads, especially the tablet ones, the ones where you can, like, rotate the screen and use them as a tablet PC. I've always loved those. I wouldn't mind having one someday. My days of collecting computers aren't as, you know, broad as they used to be, because I have too many machines right now that I sort of don't really want. A lot of them are kind of crap. There's ones I'm obviously going to keep are, like, my R51 and stuff like that, and you know, and I do have some projects for some other ones in that I will get to at some point. But I'm not really collecting anything right now, but once I clear out some stuff, I might start, you know, getting a few more machines. So, because right now I think I have about 20 computers overall. I have a lot, because I just haven't gotten rid of anything in the last couple of years. So, but yeah, there are several ThinkPad models that I wouldn't mind having, like you know, some of the classic 90s ones, as well as, you know, a couple from the 2000s, some of the tablet PC ones. I wouldn't mind having some of those. Next question is, are you albino or just very blonde? Both. No, I am actually albino, yes. I have what's called albinism. It has some full fucking name, but I don't even know what it is. But yes, I am albino, and that just doesn't affect the way I look. My vision impairment, which I've mentioned before, is actually part of my disability. I don't like to say that I'm disabled. I really don't. In fact, I find it really demoralizing calling my, like, I don't like the word disabled. Like, I'm not gonna stop you from using it, of course. And like, no, that's just stupid. I don't like to see myself as disabled, because the word disabled is a negative word. It's disabled. Like, I don't like that at all. I think it's horrible. But, you know, that's the word people use, and they're going to use it, of course. I'm not going to tell anyone not to. I'm not one of those SJW loser cunts who likes to say, oh, you can't say this. Like, fuck off. You can say what you, the people should just be able to say what they want. It's free, like, free speech. Like, with it, like, there's a difference between free speech and hate speech, so I believe in free speech. But, yes, I am albino, so that affects the color of, you know, color of my hair and color of my skin. And, you know, you can see my beard, you know, all that. It's, you know, pretty white, but as I've gotten older, I've sort of learned to adapt with the way I look, and now I actually look like a human being. I hated the way I looked as a kid. Now I can actually sort of make myself look half decent and not look like some freak of nature, but yeah, and it's hard to see in this kind of crappy lighting how white I am, but I'm pretty white, so. But yes, I am albino, so that is an actual thing. I'm going on a bit of a tangent, but this is one thing that people don't seem to really understand, is that there's different levels of albinism, right? So a lot of people when they think of albino, they think of just this really white person and they have the pink eyes. That's not true. My eyes are blue. You can see that. My eyes are blue. So there's different varying degrees of, like, being an albino. There is. And so I'm slightly less of one because I have it depends on the level of what's called melanin in your skin. I've got a little bit more than what would be considered the typical albino. So that's why my eyes are blue. That's why my skin isn't quite as white as some others, and my hair has got more of a goldish tinge to it in the right lighting compared to some others. My hair is not completely white. It's white as like a piece of paper, for example. Like, it's, you know, my hair is actually got a bit of a gold color to it. My hair color is what's called platinum blonde. So that's why, like, that's actually what it's called. That's the shade of my hair is platinum blonde. So, yeah. So yes, but I actually am albino, and that doesn't affect just your skin, but it's also a visual impairment too, that's part of it. That's why I can't see very well, that's why my glasses, you can see a very, very thick lenses, I don't know you can see that on camera. I can't even see the viewfinder anymore, because I need to wear these things constantly. But I've learned to adapt over the last 20 years of my life, so, yeah, 21 years of my life, sorry. So, yeah, That's it. That's my life. This is just the way I've always been. Some people like to hate or whatever, but like, I'm an adult. I don't care. It was a problem when I was younger, and now it's not. So whatever. It doesn't matter. Next question is: any new computer videos planned? Yes, of course. That's the bread and butter of my channel. Now I know I've been trying to diversify my content with other stuff. Back in 2016, I tried the commentary videos where I'll just be narrating over some gameplay about some story that happened in my life at some point. I don't have many stories, that's why I haven't done many of those videos as well, as I kind of just didn't like the format as much. I sort of, you know. Do apologize about that, my SD card filled up. However, back to what the question was about. So yeah, like I said, I did try to diversify my content a bit over the last couple of years. Like I mentioned, I did commentary videos I did in 2016, as well as my live stream stuff I did last year and earlier this year too. But yes, there are more computer videos coming, and you know, now that you know I've got some other things going on in my life, you know, YouTube, and I'm not going to be quitting YouTube, of course not. Like, well, I wouldn't do that. I love doing YouTube videos. But for now, it's sort of like, I'm just going to upload what I want. And if people like it, then they like it. If they don't, well, then I learn from that mistake and I, you know, don't do it again. Or the ones that do, you know, I'll do it for them, you know? But yeah, I am going to have more computer videos coming soon. I do have some projects I want to work on. I just need to find the time now that I've got a full-time job. A lot of the time when I come home from work, I'm exhausted, so usually weekends I'm going to try and do videos just like I'm doing right now. It's the weekend, I actually found time to actually make a video, so I'm going to try and, you know, now that I'm sort of settled into work a bit more, you know, I sort of know what I'm doing mostly. I'm still sort of learning the ropes a bit. Now that I'm settled in a bit more, I should be able to find time for videos, and so I'll just make videos when I can, and there will be definitely some computer videos to come, because that's the bread and butter of my channel, so, yeah. And the last question for today is, how does your ThinkPad T420 hold up for after almost 4 years? Now that's a good question, because, as you can see, right now I'm actually not using my T420. This is not the T420, as you can see, this is an old R61. What happened to the T420? Well, back in April, I decided to trade it with my dad's laptop. He has a ThinkPad T420S that's really beaten to shit. I don't remember where I put it. I think I put it in my cupboard somewhere. It's not functional at the moment. Well, it technically boots, but it's in such a state of disrepair that it's, you know, not. I don't consider it functional. That's why I'm using this old Core 2 Duo. But my dad needed a new laptop. and my T420, I wanted to upgrade this year anyway. I wanted something a bit more modern. I had that T420 for the last 4 years, and it was already a 3-year-old laptop when I bought it. I bought it as a refurb, as a refurbished machine. And so it was about 7 years old. I wanted something a bit more modern, a bit thinner, a bit smaller. This R61 is a temporary laptop until I can afford to buy a new one. You know, I wanted something just, a bit smaller and thinner. So my dad needed a new laptop, so I was just like, all right, well, you know, I'm not really using the T420 much these days, and he needs it more than I do. So, you know, he's got it now as well. So he has a T420. So it's still in my house, but it's not my machine anymore. But how has it held up over the last 4 years? Honestly, great. In terms of, like, physical, how it held up in terms of wear, pretty good. I'm not too hard on my laptops. They're not my daily drivers. For the last 5 years, I've been using a desktop as my daily driver, so, like, I'm not constantly hammering on the machines. But that T420 got me through my 3 years at TAFE, you know, studying for my Certificate 3 in IT. Yeah, that T420 got me, through my studying years as well as, through last year as well. I didn't use it a whole lot last year, but, it got me through my last period of education, and it held up great. They're still really good laptops. If you can find one for pretty cheap, I'd still recommend buying them. On one condition: if you don't need graphics power. Graphics performance, especially on the Intel integrated graphics models, which is what I had, the HD 3000, is really starting to show its age. Sandy Bridge, as good as a platform as it is still, the integrated graphics chipset is just not good anymore. It's a 7-year-old platform, and the integrated graphics especially is showing its age. If you find a model with the NVIDIA Quadro models, I forget what Quadro they had in them, the T420s, but if you find one of those, I don't know if those have the Optimus switching abilities. Someone can correct me in the comments if they do. I don't know if they do or not. I know someone who had one. I don't know if it did that, if it had the ability to switch between the integrated and the NVIDIA card on the fly, like some laptops back then did. I know it was hit or miss back in 2011 when that was a feature, when that was a thing. It's still a thing these days, but that's when it first started, I think, was in back then. I don't know if the Quadro machines had that ability for just the switching on the fly graphics. Yeah, it's a good laptop. If you don't need graphics performance, the T420 will still hold up very well. Still has the best keyboard in terms of ThinkPads, in my opinion. In terms of any laptop, in my opinion, because even though the new ThinkPads have a good keyboard, it feels good, the keyboard, the layout's wrong. The great thing about these classic ThinkPads, this R61's like this, and they did this up until a T420, is that it's a 7-row keyboard. So you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, the arrow keys, and they count as 1. What I like is the function keys aren't all, it's laid out like a desktop keyboard. So up the top here, you have the insert, home, insert, delete, home, and page up, page down. That's exactly the same as it is on a desktop keyboard. On the newer machines, they've rearranged them, and a lot of our laptops, they rearrange them to sort of fit in a smaller body, but these older ThinkPads, up until the T420, this is not a T420, but up until then, they had this keyboard, and it's great. It's still probably my favorite laptop keyboard to date. I still think it's better than the newer ones. They did come out with a ThinkPad, the retro ThinkPad, the ThinkPad 25th anniversary, which did have the classic keyboard in it, but that was a limited production thing. But I do wish Lenovo made a permanent version of that. That would be nice. But yeah, T420 held up pretty well over the last 4 years. In terms of wear, I didn't wear it down pretty much, really much at all. The keyboard was a little bit shiny, but that's because I did a lot of typing on that. Not as much as I would on my desktop, but I'm not too hard on the keyboards. Yeah, I'm not too hard on my keyboards. I tend to, type pretty lightly, so yeah, I'm not that hard on them. In terms of actual system performance, it's pretty good. Even under Windows 10, with the exception of the integrated graphics, I wouldn't recommend HD 3000 unless if all you're doing is web browsing. It can do YouTube fine. That's really as much as you really want to do with it. Maybe some old games like GTA 3 or San Andreas would probably run on there fine. But, like, don't expect anything amazing out of the HD 3000 graphics. They're not that great. Try and find a T430 if you can, because while it doesn't have the nice, that doesn't have the older classic keyboard, it has much better integrated graphics as HD 4000. So I'd recommend a T430 instead. Also, it also has USB 3.0. That's one thing a T420 lacks, is USB 3. So if you have newer flash drives and external hard drives, you're going to want to have USB 3.0 available, because 2.0 just sucks. That is the end of the questions for the Q&A here. Now, I don't know if this is in two parts or not. By the time it's uploaded, of course, I'll know, but I looked at the footage when I was copying it when my SD card filled up, and it's over an hour, so I'm going to have to trim that down. So it might be in two parts, it might not be, who knows. I said it in a video at the start of the video, it probably wouldn't be, but it might be now that I'm thinking about it. So, anyways, so I hope you enjoyed this video. Like I said, I'm working full-time now, so that videos, I'll try and record videos when I can. There's not going to be any particular schedule. Then I'm just gonna do videos when I can. I'm not sure what I'm doing with live streams yet. If you still want me to do live streams, tell me in the comments. Or if you don't want to, let me know in the comments if you actually do want to see them or not. And I've had some different ideas for a couple of other things that I'll talk about sometime in the future. But like I said, I'm working full time, so that takes up a lot of my time now. I have a full time, full paying job, so that's sort of the main focus of my life these days, and is my work, as well as but YouTube is still a thing that I want to do. I love doing YouTube, and I hope I can continue, even if my channel has sort of dwindled down in terms of views and stuff lately. Over the last probably year or so, it hasn't been as great as it once was, even though I'm gaining subscribers, but I'm not gaining views as much as I thought I would be. But I've sort of gotten over a lot of that now that I don't really care, so yeah, anyways. Hope you enjoyed this video, and yeah, thank you for watching. I'll see you in my next one. So thanks for watching my video, guys. I really hope you enjoyed it. If you liked it, hit the thumbs up button. If you didn't, well then hit the other button. Check out another video that's being suggested to you right now, it should be on the screen. And as always, thanks for watching. I'll see you guys in my next video.